Welcome to the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. We're here in Mount Van Hovenburg for some biathlon action. We've had some snow fall overnight, and we have had some cross-country racing on the track already today. But it is time for the biathletes to take to the stage. This competition is the men's 10-kilometer sprint event. So three laps of the 3.3-kilometer track with two visits to the range. The first visit prone, the second visit standing. It's a time trial format with the biathletes setting off at 30-second intervals. We've got 40 biathletes in the field, so it will take them 20 minutes to get all out onto the course. And at that stage, we will have the whole track full, I would imagine, because number one is going to take slightly more than 20 minutes to go around the full 10K. So the start order is randomly drawn in groups. So yeah, three 3.3 laps, and it kind of takes us up midway up the tracks here at Mount Van Hovenburg. Got a steep climb in the middle profile of the course. It is a steep climb, and it's all up or down here at the biathlon track. Built for the 1980 Olympic Games, Mount Van Hovenburg has been hosting Olympic sports since 1932, with a bobsleigh being built here. So getting us underway, the Canadian, William Moineau. Watch out for Yannick Wojciech in the top eight there. He was eighth in the 15K competition. Also watch out for Axel Garnier from France, bronze in that event. Starting at number 18. Van Ledger, the flag carrier for the US team, local boy. And the Norwegian, he's not starting 30. Ojan Musseng and Vadim Corrales won gold and silver, 30 and 31. So we're moments away from the start. The air temperature has just hovered around that plus one, minus one mark, and it's been changing its mind between snowing and sleeting and raining throughout the day. So we are almost ready to go. The biathletes will have spent the last 10 minutes zeroing their weapons, just setting their sights. There's not much wind on the shooting range, which is good news. You can see the snow coming down. It's coming down fairly vertically. So a lot of experience on the IBU Cup. A lot of these athletes have not even reached that level yet to score points on the IBU Cup. So from Senep FX Garneau, William Moineau of Canada will be the number one skier out on course. And we're off and underway. William Moineau, 26th in the 15K competition. Off and running. You can see the course is fairly chewed up already from the cross-country competition that was earlier on this morning. So maybe an early start number might be an advantage today. as Wojciech Janik of Poland gets underway, and he'll be certainly hoping that that is the case, that the track slows down with every skier that does their best to generate power and speed. Roman Borodzik. And Borovik from Ukraine is off and running. And he's going for it, going hard. So a fast start for the Ukrainian. Number four from Finland. Watch out for him as well, Matias Majala. Seventh in the 15K competition. And we will look to these first athletes for those initial split times.
Good performance for him in the
short individual competition.
A good start there for the Finn. John Fieser of the Netherlands from Nord University. Just looking at how well the skis are running, how much glide that they're getting with each of the steps. Doesn't seem to have the same speed out as the previous skier. Will Neuhaus is next at the start, but he's not at the start. So a DNS for the Australian, Will Neuhaus. As we go out onto the track, and we're watching Wojciech Janik of Poland, the number two. Expect him to set an early quick pace. Simon Gauthier from Laval University. 28th in the 15K competition. So Gauthier up that first initial hill. And Chon Yun-pil from Korea.
Chon Yun-pil from Korea, he was 28th in the opening day competition.
For a lot of these athletes, it's just the experience of being sent to the University Games as a representative of
the Korean out onto the track. And you can see how soft it is already up that first climb. We'll be going around that three times with 40 skiers. So Thibaut Frechard from France. Disappointed with his placing in the 15K. Seven misses though in that day. Nathan Livingwood from Paul Smith College, 19 years old.
And the trails designed at that college by John
Livingwood starting well. So we're seeing the Canadian William Moyner being caught here by Wojciech Janik. That was what we kind of expected as they're approaching the 2.2-kilometre mark. In the initial top 10, we're looking at the Finn, Matias Majala with bib 4 and bib 2, Wojciech Janik, to set our early pace as we come into the range for the first time. So we waited for that 2.2 kilometer split. You can see how the glide, it's not running particularly quickly, the track now. Extra effort needed to generate the speed along this flat section. And as they go through the 2.2 kilometer mark, you can see that Wojciech Janik has a 29 second lead over the Canadian. Now you might say, well, he's in the lead, why should that be not more than 30 seconds? Well, it depends on exactly when they started. It's 30 second intervals, but you can decide exactly when you go. And that's all measured by the wand at the start. So although any budding mathematicians out there might be thinking, well, he's ahead, why is he not more than 30 seconds up? That's why. And the pole looking very good. But it will come down to the shooting. We're visiting the range twice. Oh, you can see how sketchy it is around that corner. And I think that Wojciech Janik skied it definitely better, but the speed that William Moyno was able to carry out of the corner. And trying to get back into the lead. But Janik has the power up the hill here. So this is the final hill before they drop down in towards the stadium. Oh, and I'm just looking, and the Finn Majala has come in 30 seconds back on the 2.2 kilometer. So maybe his wax not running particularly well. So his ski speed not as good as the pole. Borovik, the Ukrainian, looking quite good, 11 seconds back on Janik at the 2.2 mark, 13 seconds back at the 2.9 mark as we come into the shooting. We're watching Axel Garnier start here before we go back to the range. Axel Garnier from France, bronze in the 15K competition. Definitely one to watch, one of the early starters who could really pull a surprise here. And also Kirill Bauer, well, didn't ski, well, he skied well in the 15K, but shot particularly badly. So we know that he has the speed, but if he can improve on his accuracy and get that shooting percentage right up, then he will have a good chance. So, well, despite, yeah, a fast first lap, we've had two misses for Moyno. And he will go on to the penalty loop. So it's penalty loops today. And you can see their number two, Janik, also missed twice. Coming into the range now is the Finn. So coming into the range 27 seconds back, but if he can go clear here, to Majala. The shooting from the prone position, shooting at a target about the size of a golf ball. Looking good. Don't want to miss the last one. Oh, missed the last one. It's a shame. So 80% and one penalty loop. So as the exit is shooting, it is the Ukrainian Borovik that is leading. As we watch number 19, Kirill Bauer. Bauer not made the first split yet. Przemyslaw Panacz from Poland. Had a disappointing 15K, did Panacz. It's mostly down to the shooting. Stefan Kinash from Ukraine, part of that medal-winning team for Ukraine in the team competition. Mixed relay, along with Yulia Horodna. So into the range now, we're looking at John Visa from the Netherlands. That's one miss so far. So not a good shoot for John Visa. Four misses for the athlete from the Netherlands. Number two there, Wojciech Janik. Lying in third place. The leader now on the track, but that lead will be short-lived. Wojciech Janik. Has done his three penalty loops. See that he has been overtaken by the Ukraine, the skier from the Ukraine. So early days yet. The Frenchman has shot clear, Tibor Frechard, number nine. So number nine is leading as they came out of the range for the first time. So Frechard looking good. Frechard didn't ski particularly well or quickly on the first lap, but shot clean. And Frechard leading as they came out of the chute. So that is Oyan Musang, the silver medalist in the 15K competition. And Vadim Kurales, gold medalist in the 15K competition. And off, and the power and speed as they go out of the start. Zidda will be different from some of the early starters that we've seen. Number nine there is Tibor Frechard. He is currently in the lead, shot clean on his first visit to the range. And he leads. He's leading at the split as they left the range. Alexander Mukin as well, 13, just 5 seconds behind on the exit of the first chute. So watch out for Mukin when he comes around. There is the gold medalist from the 15K, wearing bib 31, Vadim Kurales. So we've got a new leader coming out of the range. Number 15 is Dmitry Hushak from Ukraine. Shot clean and is 6 seconds ahead of Fresher. So, initial 2.2 kilometer split. Yannick was holding the lead there. Yannick held the lead going into the shooting, but missed three times. So those three penalty loops really cost Yannick. So as they go through the 5.5 kilometer mark, Borovic is ahead of Yannick by 35 seconds. Borovic with one miss and Yannick with three. So number 19, Kirill Bauer, into the shoot for the first time. What a slow build up to the first shot there, just making sure. Oh, and one miss for Kirill Bauer. The shooting speed was okay, shot in 34 seconds, but he will have to do a penalty loop. So it's Ukraine versus Ukraine. Number 15 there, Dmitry Hushak. Hushak leading as he came out of shooting one. Shot clean with a quick shooting time speed, 32 seconds for his visit to the range. But he wasn't particularly quick. He's only seventh fastest as he went in to the shooting, so skiing not so fast. Number 18 there, Axel Garnier. Garnier lying in third place as he left the range. He shot clean. It took him 35 seconds, so he lost about 3 seconds on the shoot. Well, at 5.5k, we've got a new leader now, the Frenchman Fresher. And at 2.2k, we're looking at Oyan Musang, the silver medalist in the 15k competition. And he is 6 seconds back on Yannick. And Yannick skied well on these initial intermediate times, but really lost it with three misses on the first shoot.
Around, and Yannick had
So Yannick, number two, skiing very fast. And Yannick right back in the contest there because he shot clean on the second visit to the range. So we're looking at Vadim Kuralis, the gold medalist from the 15K competition. And the ski speed of Wojciech Janik, skiing very fast indeed as he goes on to his third and final lap. He'll be rueing those misses on the first visit to the range. Second time standing, shot clean. And Janik will set the early pace. Alexandra Mukin from Kazakhstan, just struggling with some of these technical turns on the descent. Oh, Mukin doesn't look very happy there. So coming into the range for the second time, it is Thibault Frachard, shooting standing, shooting from right to left. He can go clean here. He's got a good chance of taking the early lead. And this is so one penalty loop required for the Frenchman. So Frachard was going into that shoot in the lead. But coming out, he's going to drop back slightly on Yannick. So I can tell you that the silver medalist from the 15K competition, Oyan Musang, number 30, has taken the lead. Leaving the shooting, shot clean, and he's 9.5 seconds up over the Ukrainian Hushak at that point. So Yannick will cross the line and take the lead. But there are some quicker skiers. Mukin missing two. That's a disappointment for Mukin. Shot clean first time round and dropped two. So we'll have to ski those two penalty loops. On there. Someone perhaps going the wrong way, having to cut back onto the track as we watch number four, Matias Majala of Finland, and number one, William Moino. Chun Yunpil. So leading. After the second shoot is Frachard of France, Thibault Frachard, and Dmitry Hushak Mitri Shrushak. Well, very fast shooting time. Shrushak, 25 seconds for his shoot. So we're watching number 30 here, Oyan Musang. He is leading. He's onto his second lap and leading as he left that shooting range for the first time. Musang skiing very quickly as well. So skiing well, shooting well. That's what's going to bring him the win. So at the 8.9 kilometer mark, Yannick is across in first place, having started with bib three, he now leads, or bib two, he now leads. Overtaken the Canadian. And Yannick was in fourth place as he left the shooting too. He's got some other skiers that are kind of come and potentially knock him down, but he will take the lead. He will be first across the line. Yeah, we were watching Axel Garnier. He was, that wasn't Axel Garnier. Axel Garnier was standing with bib 18. He was the second time into the range. Axel Garnier with four misses. Disappointing for his shooting today. Disappointing shooting from the Frenchman. So Yannick of Poland is very close to the finish now. He's gone through the 9.6 kilometer mark. So we're going to see the first skier across the line who will set the early pace. As we watch Alexandra Mukin from Kazakhstan. Mukin lying in third as he came out of the range ahead of Yannick. And this is Yannick now into the stadium, and you can see how slushy the snow is becoming. Final turn for the pole. And Wojciech Yannick, who has skied very well, just had three misses on the first visit to the range and skied very quickly to make up for those misses. 28.39, that's the time to beat. And that will hold for a few skiers, but there are quicker skiers that are still out on the track. Watch out for Alexandra Mukin, Prushak of Ukraine, Kirill Bauer of Kazakhstan. And from the USA, Bjorn Westerveld. Westerveld skiing well. There is Oyan Musang, starting 30. Leading at the 5.5 kilometer mark. There's the American. Nobody in front of us is faster One miss in the second visit to the range for Vesterveld. As we look for the American, here he is. Bjorn Vesterveld from the University of Vermont, 20 years old, chief from Stowe in Vermont, majoring in mechanical engineering. He began his biathlon at the age of 13 in Craftsbury. He's now training with the Craftsbury Biathlon. Championships, and this is William Moyno crossing the line, fourth place. So watch the American, Vesterveld. So Yannick leads in the finish. We've got a couple of athletes who are going to challenge that time very shortly. Alexandra Mukin, start number 13, as we watch the potential winner here. If you can shoot clean, then this will be a real opportunity. He's gone into the range in the lead, 16 seconds up. A clean shoot here would give Oyan Musang a very good chance of taking gold today. One miss. Two misses. Wow. That is bad luck for the Norwegian. Three misses. Three penalty loops, and the lead that he could have established has slipped away. So looking at the last split, it looks like Alexandra Mukin is going to come through and take the lead away from Yannick. Freshar's just come through at the finish in second, but Mukin, 22 seconds up at the final split. Is Chun Jun Pil of Korea. A long way back. Kirill Bauer there, number 19 behind him, looking a little bit labored, Bauer. He was lying in second place, going out of the shooting. Oh, and Musang, wow. With those misses, he is now into second place, 7 seconds back on Vesterveld. So 13 from Kazakhstan. It is Alexander Mukin who will take the early lead and across in 25 seconds ahead. So Mukin leads with a 28:13.7 and a good ski. Two misses in total for Alexander Mukin. So now we have to wait and see. There are still skiers who could challenge. One of them is Rushak with start number 15 from Ukraine. He's gone through the 9.6 kilometer split at 21 seconds back. He's not going to challenge Mukin with that. And he did look a little bit tired. So now it comes down to the skiing skills of Oyan Musang. He knows that he would have missed, had to do those three penalty loops, he knows the opportunity of a win. Well, it's still there, but he's gonna have to work for it. And third place for Cabrera. as we watch Dmitry Hrashchik will come across in second, or is it third? Just in second, beats Yannick by 0.8 of a second. So that's the podium as it stands in the finish. Mukin, Hrashchik and Yannick. But watch for Vestervelt, the American, wearing bib 20. So Vestervelt at 8.9 kilometers is 8 seconds ahead of Alexandra Mukin. Approaching the 9.6 kilometer mark now. Kirill Bauer has just gone through that, 13 seconds back on Mukin. And Vestervelt has gone through in the lead, 12 seconds ahead of Mukin. So Vestervelt with a great ski. As we watch Cale Woods cross the line, this is Maciej Badan. So we need to see Vestervelt as he comes in and down the hill past the lodge. Little snowmen are going to watch on and wave on. There he is in the distance as he comes down the hill. Vestervelt. Bjorn Vestervelt from the United States. There is Kirill Bauer. Bauer will go across in second, but look how Vestervelt is skiing. Vestervelt absolutely flying, takes the lead by 13 seconds. Kirill Bauer on his knees in third, but taking the lead, the American. In the distance there, bid 20 has taken potentially a medal for the United States. So coming in from the back, we've got Moose Seng of Norway. We've got Tublekov of Kazakhstan also posting some good times. Shot clean on their last visit to the range. In fact, it's been clean all day. Tublekov, as Go Shochiro crosses the line in 10th place. We see the current leader, Bjorn Vestervelt. Super happy. So now we're getting down to the final play out. Everyone has been through, not quite, not everyone has quite been through the range. There is Haugen. Got five more to visit the range the second time. So watch out for Musang and Tufelikov. Tenke Tubelikov from Kazakhstan, going big 35. And he is quickest out of the shooting range. A good way ahead. Does he have the speed on the snow? It's all going to come down to this last lap for him. Vestervelt had such speed on the snow. So Musang is through at 8.9 and is just 4 seconds back on the American. As we watch bib 35 To Belikov from Kazakhstan. Hasn't reached that split yet. The 25, Van Ledger from the USA. Lying down in 18th place as he left the chute. So this is the Norwegian coming into the final split. Now he was 4 seconds down and he's more. Vestervelt has skied so fast. And you can see Musang missing three times. He'll be ruining those misses. But definitely a potential spot on the podium for the Norwegian. I don't think he's going to challenge for gold. Vestervelt is watching in the finish. Currently in the finish, it's Vestervelt, Alexander Mukin in silver, Kirill Bauer in third. Musang is going to definitely place on the podium. Will it be silver? Will it be bronze? Bauer 31 seconds back on the current leader in the finish. So Vestervelt's got, so Musang's got a great chance of getting bronze, but can he make it silver? So here we go, Mukin is 13 seconds back. And Musang gets ahead of him. So second place for Ørjan Musang. Vestervelt still leads. Those three misses really saw paid to the challenge from the Norwegian. So it's not over because there is still the Kazakhstani posting some great times at the intermediates, bib 35. Around the corner, doesn't look to really be carrying the speed on the descents. Now Bjorn Vestervelt is the leader at the last split. And Tubelikov, well, he's going to cross the line with a 15-second advantage. So 15 seconds to play with from in the last 400 meters. You would think that would be enough. Bekente Tubelikov from Kazakhstan challenging for the gold. Vestervelt currently lying in first place, the American. Oh, he looks absolutely spent. Oh, he's gonna have to, oh, it doesn't look like he's carrying very much speed here. He had 13 seconds, that should be enough. But he's gonna have to really go over the final push. Oh, it's gonna be neck and neck. We're looking at bib 35. He's got, it's gonna be close, but I think it could well be enough. He does it by 8 seconds. Tubelikov takes the gold medal and pushes Bjorn Vestervelt from the USA into silver medal position. And Ørjan Musang of Norway will take the bronze. Are still skiers left on the course, but no one is going to challenge the podium as far as I can see. We have an asterisk next to the graphic of Ørjan Musang. What that is, don't know what that is, we'll find out what he's tracking. But when there is an asterisk next to a competitor, Yeah, so there is on the timing an asterisk next to Oyen Musang, which will be some kind of jury inquiry. Might be that didn't ski the penalty loops. But yeah, we'll have to wait and see what that asterisk means that's next to the bronze medalist's name. But no doubt on the gold.
Asterisk means some sort of disqualification for the Norwegian, because you have a Kazakhstan racer in first and third with right in the middle, Bjorn Westerdahl, with an amazing silver medal.
So we'll wait and see what the jury decide with the Norwegian, but we've definitely got Kazakhstan in gold. And we will see and keep you up to date. So the final skiers out on the track. Mikhail Zajoral from the Czech Republic. And number 40 there, Matthias Ingrid Haugen. Approaching the final split time. Zarao. Final hill for him. He's approaching the 9.6 kilometer mark. And he goes across the line there, and across the split time in 20th position, 2 minutes 53 back. So Tua Lubakov is leading, and we watch Nika Zajoral of the Czech Republic. He's going to be coming in around about 20th position. Will he beat Van Ledger, who's currently in 20th? Yes, he does. And knocks the American down to 21st. So William Whaling Eng from Canada will be the last skier to cross the line. And finishes in 29th spot.
Things winding down, you'll have the mascot and the real ceremony today after this.
So the final athlete, I think, across the line is going to be Romeo Champagne, and Romeo Champagne finishes in 33rd position. But it is going to be Kazakhstan that will be cracking the champagne later on tonight.
So all of our competitors across the finish line, we expect...
So everyone across the finish now. There'll be a little bit of a jury inquiry, I think, into the Norwegian.
We'll find out. Reminder that the women's sprint competition will take place at 3:25 today. And that this competition
current,
is not the end of
podium
the,
stands
of
as
there is a
Kazakhstan in gold
today. That sets up your
to Lubakov. Vestervelt of the United States of America. And, well, just vanishing from my leaderboard is the Norwegian Øyen Moseng. So I can only assume that the Norwegian has been disqualified. I don't exactly know what the infringement was, something to do with the shooting range. And it has promoted Alexandra Mukin into the bronze medal position. So Alexandra Mukin gets the bronze with the disqualification of the Norwegian Øyen Moseng. I'll try and find out why that happened and what he was disqualified for. But Kazakhstan, look at that, packing the top five. Four athletes in the top five, with only Bjørn Vestervelt of the United States separating them with that fantastic silver medal. Øyen Moseng, yeah, knocked down the leaderboard there. All I can think of is that he didn't ski a penalty loop and has been penalized. Well, great work for the Kazakhstan team. Well, going into these games, we thought that Kazakhstan would perform well. They kind of underperformed in the 15K short competition. Well, they won the gold with Vadim Kurales. Alexandra Mukin in sixth. But everyone who didn't shoot well, shot well today. So let's have a look at the highlights from this race. Bib number 13, Alexandra Mukin. Off and running. He ended up with the bronze medal. Mukin missed twice in total. Clean on the prone shoot, missed twice on the standing. Penalties for Mukin from the standing shoot. The American Vestervelt. Well, he missed one on each of his visits to the range, but his ski speed was very impressive. That with just one of those misses, if just one hadn't happened, then you've got to say that Vestervelt would have probably taken the gold. But to Lubakov, came through absolutely clean. Didn't have the speed on the snow of Vestervelt. And hung on. You could see how exhausted he was across the line, but shot clean and took the gold. So I hope you've enjoyed the biathlon men's 10K sprint. Time for the mascot ceremony very shortly.
The mascot ceremony will be coming right up. Please stay with us.
One.
For the biathlon men's 10-kilometer sprint, please welcome the athletes.
So time for the mascot ceremony of the men's 10K sprint.
We'd like to remind everybody that there's been an update. The medal ceremony will be taking place immediately following the mascot ceremony behind the Mountain Pass Base Lodge in the Medals Plaza. Thank you.
Just start moving real slow and I'll get the idea. Kick me in the shin if you got it. You're the boss. You got the moves.
So some kind of technical issue with the music, I think, before the mascot ceremony can begin.
If you change over,
We've got the women's competition coming up in around about an hour and a half's time, an hour and 20 minutes. 7.5K sprint.
Ladies and gentlemen, the mascot ceremony for biathlon, 10-kilometer men's sprint. Please welcome the winners.
So time to welcome the winners out, and hats off to Kazakhstan today. Packed four skiers into the top five.
Mascots will be presented by Lila Fay on behalf of the Lake Placid FISU Organizing Committee. In third place, representing Kazakhstan, Alexander Mukin.
Alexander Mukin from Kazakhstan in third place. Two misses on the range.
In second place, representing USA, Bjorn Westervelt.
Bjorn Westervelt from the United States of America, from the University of Vermont. Also two misses.
First place and biathlon men's 10-kilometer sprint champion, representing Kazakhstan, Bekentai Terbelov.
Bekentai Terbelov is in gold medal position, the only biathlete to go clean today. And he was not just clean, he was also very fast on the range as well. His shooting times were in the 24 seconds.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games winners.
When you go on this side.
So congratulations to our medalists. And if
ladies
you enjoyed
and
the men's competition.
The mascot ceremony for the biathlon men's 10-kilometer sprint.
Tune in for the women's 7.5K sprint, which will be happening very shortly. So Kazakhstan with Mukin and to Lubikov.
We're going to be having the medal ceremony immediately following the mascot ceremony behind the Mountain Pass Base Lodge.
And
in
a smile from
Plaza.
Bjorn Westervelt. It is Kazakhstan with Tulubikov in first, Bjorn Westervelt of the USA in silver, and Alexandra Mukin also from Kazakhstan in the bronze.